actually jobs like first is our government sector. Number two is a private sector. So what easy student can focus is, he or she can focus for government sector jobs or private sector jobs. This is the first thing that we have to keep in mind. The second is, you take either government or a private sector. One and two means the previous slide what we have said, one is government sector, second is the private sector. You take one or two. So we can divide here again. We can divide here. Like four I, other is software side. In core side, we have several, like you are studying in your engineering, DSP, you are studying DSP?
Yes, sir.
You are going to study digital image processing. You are going to study neural networks. You are going to study micro processor and microcontroller. And you are going to study, you already had studied STLD based. You already had studied EDC and network theory. And you also had studied C, and you also had will be studying VLSI. These are the main subjects that core side means we mean by say about this. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, core side, we can put this. Why I have kept one by one, I will come. In DSP, digital image, digital signal processing, you are going to study FIR filter, IIR filter, etc. FFT also, you can put FFT also. In image processing, you are going to study like haze removal, etc. Like image compression, that also you can take, etc. In neural networks, you are going to compute several, like you have your artificial intelligence, AI, and you have your machine learning, and you have your deep learning, all this. In a MP means microprocessor and microcontroller, you are going to focus on like embedded system, for example. Embedded system applications. And IoT based applications. In IoT based applications, we have to understand here again, the segments are there, like two segments, like a hardware related and software. And coming to your STLD, you have like logic design, digital logic design. You have your EDC and network theory. This helps you for your analog IC design. Your C, again, this helps here in embedded software development. This is required as a core side. How it is required is some of the algorithms, some algorithms you may have to develop, some algorithms you may have to develop to see the behavior. So for this, these algorithms may be one of this FIR above mentioned, like haze removal, anything like artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, or embedded system applications, or IoT applications, anything that is above mentioned. All these six, sometimes you are forced to develop algorithm, understand the algorithm, and develop that algorithm in the C language. For that purpose, C is also essential. That's why I have kept in the core side instead of keeping the other side software side. Now coming to the VLSI, that is again here several things like you have again analog IC, you have your digital IC, you have your mixed signal IC. You have again like among them like RFIC, several like etc. And coming to your software side here, this software side. Nowadays, if you are good at your Java-based applications are there, your C++ applications, all product development, Java-based product development, C++ product development, .NET-based in development, and you have this Python-based, nowadays people are also talking about the Python-based product development. Python, I have to keep even here as well. I keep Python here. In the core side also, I'm keeping the Python. Why? Because here, based on the Python, you can Python, you can use it for different purposes, like web development also you can use, some product development also you can use, some scripting. This is scripting. I will show everything later on. Scripting for a scripting purpose in VLSI. So this is this is just a minute. And then you have this what we call this sort of XML. XML, and then you have here. This networking also I'm keeping under that, networking that is like LAN, local area network setup, and WAN, wide area network setup, etc. And then you have here system applications like a system admin. In this system administration, what you get here is system administration, like quota allotment, how much quota we have to allot to the users, security, like protection from the malware and hacking, sort of security, all this taken care by this system administrator also. So that's why this is also under software only, and etc. I can keep here, etc. So now, what is that EC student needs to understand is he or she. First of all, they have to explore their own field. They have to understand, because in engineering ECE, they are studying DSP, digital image processing, all these mentioned subjects here. If you are good at, for example, let's say, here, this, just a minute, I will show with the, for example, I will show here, SCL, Chandigarh. If you see this SCL Chandigarh, this is taken care by now Department of Space, Government of India. This sector here, these people, they develop applications related to this one here, DSP, FIR filter, IR filter, ICs they develop, and they also develop analog ICs. They also develop mixed signal ICs. They also develop RFIC, radio frequency ICs. They all like this category one, this ninth one, and this one here, this sixth one. So meaning what? If you are good at EC student, fundamentals are required, sound fundamentals. Anything that syllabus contains in DSP, you have something about FIR, let's say, some formula is there, some something is there, how actually what is the purpose of FIR, types of FIR, drawbacks of FIR, why we go for IIR filter, what drawbacks are there, such all fundamentals. I'm talking about the sound fundamentals in any of these subjects mentioned here, nine that you see. Any of this, if you have sound fundamentals, those sound fundamentals are enough to get into this company. Their notification will come. We can approach. I will show like how it is. This is one company that I want to show you. The other is. This is again our all government I'm talking now. Later on, I will go to the private sector.
Okay.
This is one government sector, SCL, what I have shown, semiconductor laboratory. The other is this one, defense electronics research laboratory. This area, I mean, this company also looks for those candidates who are having sound fundamentals. They conduct exam. If you appear their exam, what is been asked is all fundamentals from these subjects like EDC, network theory, and microwave. Microwave I did not mention. Microwave from DSP, from microprocessor. All these fundamentals. Any company you take, any company, they will ask either of these subject. Most of the questions may come. In some company, like let's say this company, defense, this company may be asking more questions from EDC and STLD and microprocessor. From these three, this company may be asking more questions, and fewer questions may be from other subjects. And this company, this semiconductor company, may be asking more questions from this 4, 5, 6, and also from ninth one. And so some portion here may be 7th and 8th. So likewise, this company may be framing the questions, and they are mostly they are focusing on fundamental questions. So any sort of fundamental question candidate should be able to answer. So if you are good at these subjects, then you can go get into this or this. Let's go to the other company. This is again another government. So by the time this comes, let's go to another company. This is another government company, this one. So here, where we go here is, if you go to this, our capabilities, and if you see this product sector and services sector, you will understand in which sector these companies are working. So if you see their products, aircraft, helicopters, like that, their products are. Now, what is required here in this aircraft is lot many things are required in the aircraft. This aircraft without electronics, no meaning of having this mechanical structure. What you see, any mechanical structure that you are seeing here is of no use without electronics. So meaning what, even this company, when they conduct any exam, they will be asking among these all mentioned 9 subjects, if you are sound at fundamentals, then definitely you can get through their exam as well. If you clear their exam, then your post will not be any any ordinary post. You will be absorbed in some higher level post in any of these government companies that I'm talking. So you will be absorbed in topmost posts. So you, in order to get into this candidate, overall India, they will conduct the exam. And overall India, you can imagine, we have whatnot. We have our IITs here. We have top, of course, here in this Indian Institute of Science, this also is there. And then we have our NITs, all NITs, and we have our IIIT, and then we have any other engineering college. So imagine all over India, from these institutes, when any other college candidate wants to compete with these students, means how much he or she should be sound enough in the basics mentioned here, all these subjects. Are you able to gauge the requirement?
Yes.
So there is no other shortcut. You only have to prepare yourself strong in network theory fundamentals, EDC fundamentals, STLD fundamentals. You just cannot get away from grasping these fundamentals. You just cannot focus on only your external passing marks or external clearing your external point of view. People, majority of the people from these other engineering colleges, what I have mentioned here, ours also falls in this category only. The problem with these students, any other engineering college students, is that they want a nice engineering degree with 85%, 90%, 95%, nice degree, minimum 85% and above they want. how they want, they don't want any fundamentals. They just want to mug up what is important for external exam. And they clear with some nice percentage. Internal, somehow they pressurize maybe the faculty going to the head of the department or management, something, some sort of things. But ultimate end result is that they will have nice percentage. But the problem is they lack in the fundamentals. They lack in all these fundamentals. Now what happens is this IIT student, if you take any IIT, you try to interact with IIT students or NIT students, how they spend their time with their studies. No candidate, I had been to NIT Warangal many times. I also, alhamdulillah, God has given me chance to just visit IIT Kharagpur and IIT Bombay. So when I had been to this IIT Bombay and IIT Kharagpur and NIT Warangal, I have seen students all the time, something they are discussing about their subject day and night. I was there in the campus actually for a period of 10 days, I think. So all these 10 days when I was taking rounds night time, they were actually going to the lab and doing something or the other. They, of course, they are spending social life as well. Some time is there for them, like 5 to maybe 8, evening 5 to 8, or maybe night time also, night 8 to 10, maybe like that. Depending upon their mood, they have their own plan. They are spending for building their physical activity. But apart from that, they are also focusing so much on their studies. That is what I have noticed. That is what I have observed. But problem with any other engineering college, what is happening is they are very, very few candidates are focusing on physical development. Like they don't, I haven't seen people playing any meaningful sport, maybe football, maybe volleyball, maybe cricket, maybe caroms, maybe any. I haven't seen majority, very few selected candidates will take part in that, and majority of the people will be wasting their time in the roaming here and there, bunking the classes, maybe some other business, but they are not focusing on studies. So that is what my observation so far in my life, so far life what I have spent in that, I have observed this one. So if at all you want to get into this this companies here, what I have mentioned, showing you now here, so you have to be good at all these subject fundamentals. How do you then build that subject knowledge? How do you build? You have to build this subject knowledge by referring standard reference books. Not that all-in-one or some other university to crack the external university paper, some all-in-one sort of books are there. Don't refer them. You have a proper planning. And you have to refer some standard books. So, for example, if EDC, if you take maybe Milman Halkias, maybe that one. Maybe STL, if you take, I couldn't remember, maybe Maurice Mano. Maurice Mano is the internationally referred book. So that one. So all from all these books, what we have to do is we have to work out the exercise problems given in the end of the every chapter. Those exercise problems we have to work out. We have to consult the faculty. We have to discuss that this is the problem that I was working. Please help me out. If faculty is unable to help you out, then there are lot many online resources. You have to Google them. Definitely you will get. That's how you have to plan. And you have to prepare notes. That is the utmost important. You have to prepare notes. Without preparing notes, we'll simply here and there, if you're grabbing something, that grasped or grabbed thing will not be going to last for longer time. So for that reason, you have to write down every point. So that's how you improve the subject knowledge. So if you improve this subject knowledge, And online some exams will be there. So those exams you have to take up. So I will shortly discuss that also. So that's how you make. I don't know. This is still taking time. So just let me refresh this one. So that's how government sector jobs. Let me go to the other one here. This is ISRO. All these are our government companies. Very few people try from this other engineering colleges. Majority of the people, IIT, Indian Institute of Science, NIT, IIIT, their target is either get into this ISRO or maybe other, like I was showing this one or this one, all these government sector companies. So here, how many? This is one. SCL, second one is this one, the third one is this Bhabha Atomic Research Center, this one, the fourth one is this Hindustan Aeronautical Limited, and sixth one, I think, this is the ISRO. Apart from that, you also have Union Public Service Commission. This is again another government sector. All this I'm telling you, showing you, not low cadre jobs, all top notch jobs. Once you got into this, you are a high profile person, going to be a high profile person. Understand?
Yes.
So imagine here, this examination link, if you go, you will understand here, previous question papers also been given. You can get them. Answer keys are there. You can cross check. You can work here. So recruitment advertisement section is there. You just go through. What happens here is in this Union Public Service Commission in India, we have top notch jobs Indian Forest Services, IFS, Indian IPS, Indian Public Service, I think, IPS, IAS, Indian Administrative Services, then IES, Indian Engineering Services. So all these are top notch. Top means top, royal. So all these Indian Forest Services, Indian Public Service, I think,
Police Service.
Thank you for correcting me. Indian Police Services, Indian Administrative Services, Indian Engineering Services. All these, you know, in all this sector, EC candidate is required. How EC candidate is required? For example, let's take this police service. Let's take police service. Today, we see this some cyber security. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
So here in this cyber security, in EC students, what happens is here in this course right subject, you also have there is something called cryptographic this thing subject. I don't know whether you have or not, but there is a cryptographic or something. Cryptography, I think. So cryptography related subjects are there in EC. So what you do here is you learn like different algorithms. For example, there are many, not one. For example, hash algorithm. For example, hash algorithm, and you have there is encryption algorithms are there. Encryption algorithms are there, and etc. Let's say etc. So now, what is required here is a EC guy is required here to maintain the cyber security activities to see that. There is no threat to the society, maybe banks, maybe if bank been robbed by some high profile hacker,
then these guys will be taking care, cyber security guys will be taking care. This is a part of this police service only.
Yes.
Similarly, in Indian forest services also, like people, what nowadays they are doing is they mount some chips on the birds. They mount some like these birds may be spying. Okay.
Yes.
So the this forest people responsibility is to ensure that in the forest there are lot many. I am talking only easy role. Okay.
Yes.
Don't be distracted. In Indian forest services, there are plenty of activities actually. But I am just concentrating easy student role. Easy student role is again to provide the security enhancement there. Similarly, in Indian administrative services, here also the easy guy will not be much playing. What is happening? In Indian administrative services, EC guy role is not technical it is, but EC guy can be absorbed in Indian administrative services. Okay.
Okay.
In Indian engineering services, here EC guy role will be the EC activities like I was talking about all these activities, all these 1 to 10 activities are again carried here in Indian engineering services. Different, like you have your electricity board, you have your railway, Indian railway, Indian electricity, Indian what is defense, Indian defense. I will talk, I did not mention here. These are all public sector actually. These are all public sector. Defense means that is not public sector. Defense related to here. Let me put a here defense. Indian defense. Indian and defense. In Indian defense again we have Indian Air Force, Indian Navy. And Indian Army, Indian Air Force, you know, Air Force means, you know, Navy means, you know, that is in the water. This is on the ground, Indian Army. Okay.
Yes.
Again, this in, you take either Indian Air Force or Indian Navy or Indian Army, you take. EC role will be there. EC role will be there. EC role is crucial again, not like in IAS. Here in IAS, EC role will not be much crucial here. Not that crucial here. But here it is crucial. Okay.
Yes.
So, but the point what I'm trying to make here is these are the jobs that if you go to this Union Public Service Commission, the other one what I have shown, other than this so far, this SCL, this DLRL and Bhabha Atomic Research Center and this Hindustan Aeronautical Limited and ISRO, apart from this, this one Union Public Service Commission, under that this will come, this will fall. Okay, all this will fall. But among this, these are the public service, like all these are the public service. But this is not the public service. This is only for Indian defense. Okay. So apart from this, what I have mentioned, I will read out few. Otherwise, I will write down here because it gets recorded. You have this ECIL, and then you have your BHEL. Every site you have to visit. All these I'm talking about government jobs. Okay.
Okay, sir.
NTPC, and then your Midhani or something is there, no? Midhani.
Yes, Midhani.
Midhani.
and you have BDL, BDL, and you have your BSNL, and you have your this you know, these are the companies, government sector companies.
Okay.
So for everything, like for example, let's say NTPC, you copy this and paste here and search for NTPC like that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So you just have to visit here and you have to see everything, like what they're doing, what activities, everything. One more power, water board also is there. That what we call, I don't know that, I have to check out. This is also government sector. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now the point here is, what is the point here is, what ECE student can do means, answer is this. ECE student needs to master all these subjects in order to get into the core side. All these subjects means, answer is yes. All these subjects he or she has to master, at least fundamental to attend this, their exams, he or she should visit all these sites. I mentioned this I did not write down here, actually I have shown you like here. SCL, their sites you have to visit. You will understand what their product is, because their exam will be based on that.
Okay.
Like for example, you see these products. If you click these products, they are doing low dropout linear voltage regulator. These are their products. Okay.
Okay.
So meaning what, they will conduct their exam will be based on that. So suppose if you go to here, work with the SCL, are you able to see where I am?
Yes, yes.
So if you go to here, the this one here, job opportunities, like that you have to visit, understand every site that I have shown you. Okay.
Okay.
So now for example, if you see this job opportunities, semiconductor laboratory offers exciting opportunities in VLSI design, R&D, fabrication, assembly and packaging, testing and quality assurance to Indian nationals. SCL also provides challenging career opportunities in design and development of MEMS products and system assembly. The recruitment of scientists and engineers is done through centralized recruitment conducted by Department of Space. Please visit careers link under ISRO. Is that clear?
Yes. Okay.
So that's how, for every website, for example, if you come to the Bhabha Atomic Research Center. So now we have to understand where they have this sort of like career or work with us.
Career.
Apply here. If you see here, this career opportunities, are you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So likewise, if you go there and you will understand, like for, let me go here, this one here, because this is the first thing that we have started, ISRO. Let me go to the ISRO. I think I have some connectivity issue. I don't know. It's loading very slow. But anyway, you got the point, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
So, to coming to your question, like what ECE students can do means, ECE students should visit all these government sector jobs, what I have mentioned. And he or she has to look at the career opportunities provided on their website. And he or she needs to understand what product they are targeting. Based on that, he or she needs to master these subjects. Okay.
Okay.
And these subjects, as I said, never ever refer all in one or sort of things. You have to refer standard books, as I said. Okay.
Okay.
And coming to the software side jobs.
Sir, one thing.
Huh.
Can I ask?
Yes, yes.
What about the some institutes are providing coachings for this kind of jobs, like for ISRO, Bhabha Atomic Research Center? Are they good or just they are doing the marketing, like sort of
majority are doing marketing, Baba.
Okay.
Majority in the market, if 100 institutes are there, means in that 98 institutes are marketing, only 2 institutes are good.
Okay.
And though who are good, we don't know. I don't know, actually. I had to check out like which are good and which are bad. Why? I don't know the reason behind is. Actually, these exams, you know, if you are really working the way I am instructing, what I am instructing, you that you take a Morris Mano and start working from the day one in your semester, and you prepare a notes and you work out the end examples, like every chapter, at the end of the every chapter, you have some list of questions. Unsolved.
Yes.
Them you have to work out. Them you have to solve. And every day, at least 1 hour, not more than 1 hour. Every day, only 1 hour enough. 1 hour you have to plan to study all these subjects. Like you are dividing in 1 hour, maybe half an hour for EDC, half an hour for network theory. But this consistently you have to do every day. Okay,
sir.
So likewise, if you plan, you really don't need those institutes to get trained, like what are the shortcuts and all like that. But still, if you feel like you need going, is not bad thing. You can go them and you can get trained yourself to clear the paper, because these exams, you know, if you go here and if you see their like how they are conducting these institutes, some good institutes, they will especially provide training for Bhabha Atomic Research Center. To get into that, you please approach us, we train you, some institutes. Okay. So I will let you know those institutes, 1 or 2 which are good in the market, by maybe tomorrow. I will just a WhatsApp message. Okay.
Okay.
So, but the point is, from the beginning, the way I'm instructing, if you study them, these core subjects, and if you target all this government, any of this company, I mentioned nearly, if you keep counting, more than 11 or 15 easily now so far.
Yes.
So that's how easy student can utilize their time. How they how he or she can utilize means, so far whatever, so far, see, you are there in now second year, right?
Third year.
You have completed already EDC network theory, right?
Yes, sir.
So in the free time, you have to master EDC and network theory. This is the one task that you have to keep. The second task you have to keep is STLD. This is the second task that you have to keep. The third task you have to keep is understanding any one language. But since currently Python is the thing that is dominating, you have to every day half an hour sit with your system and use some or the other Python programming. For example, I will show you now how you get started with Python. I will show you. Suppose, say, if you are going to this Python, this web URL, I will share with you later on. You will see some spoken tutorials here, okay?
Yes, sir.
These spoken tutorials, if you go to this somewhere here, some link I will show you shortly. Scilab is there, eSIM is there. Spoken tutorial, this section, and we are here only. Click here to know more about self here. Python self-learning course, online certificate, self-test program, and
course certification. This is enrollment charges for certification test. This is this online for say team IT students can get hands-on through. It's open to all interested learning Python respect to that and background. Access register, go to this one. Course instructor, and you have to log in with this. Maybe just log in, and this is asking me this one. So use this. This is no enrollment in Python. Let me tap here Python. Just let me see. 1992. Oh, not here. This is not the right link. Let me in just just a minute. Spoken tutorial. Click here to access Python. Yeah, here it is. Click here to access Python. Yeah, here it is. So here this is free. Everything you will get here. How I reached here, I will show one more time. I simply type here this Python for this FOSSE, FOSSEE. I have gone here this URL, and I have gone to this spoken tutorials link here. Click here to access Python spoken tutorials. This link.
Okay.
Here. From here, I landed on this page. Now all this you can cover. You have to cover. Okay. For example, let me play one. Let us see whether it is playing or not. Let's see. Yes, it is playing. Here I have to play button somewhere. Oh, I think this is the play button. I think it should come now. I think is it audible?
Somewhat, sir, not clearly.
Okay, but anyway, you got the point, right?
Yes.
So that's how, what is that you have to do in your leisure time is, that's how free, don't go to the paid one. You master first free, okay?
Okay.
So what you have to do is, see, you have completed MPMC, right?
No, in this semester we are.
In this semester is there, but yes. You have completed EDC, network theory, yes. STLD,
oh, yes.
And one more subject I forgot here to mention, that is EMTL.
EMTL, yes.
This you have finished, right?
Yes.
So now in your free time, you have to somehow master this STLD, EDC, network theory, EMTL. Master means just master. There is no other word. Master means you have to excel. Any question comes means you should be in a position to answer that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I'm sorry to
sir, communication.
Control systems also forgotten. Control systems, and you mentioned that communication. That also I forgotten. Okay. So, whether you completed control systems?
No, it is also in this.
Okay. But now what you can do is STLD, EDC, network theory, EMTL. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Then you can daily morning two subjects and night two subjects and Python. Okay.
Okay.
So Python, one more I will show. That is also very good on YouTube. Python as thing. This one, Python scripting
tutorial for beginners. This one.
Okay, sir.
One hour, I think this one, 1 hour session. So this one also, you have to spare time to learn from this also.
Okay.
This is Python for scripting. Why it is, there are many other, why I'm focusing on scripting, because this scripting helps you here in the core industry. To get into the core industry, it helps you.
Okay.
Other, there are lot many using Python, you can do lot many things. But what is required to get into the core is scripting is required.
Okay.
So that's why.
And this, framework, sir.
This I'm scripting means like automate. You have to automate the work instead of, let's say, I am typing each command. Earlier we typed, do you remember? If you remember, we had gone to CMD.
Yes, yes.
In the CMD, we were typing like iVerilog.
Yes.
We were typing iVerilog like that, no?
Yes, sir.
Instead of typing all this typed command, we have to keep in one file. And that master file we have to run.
Okay.
So the means what you are actually automating, required things you are keeping in one thing, and only one click, everything will run.
Okay.
So likewise in VLSI, there are lot many things to automate. We did only ABCD. There are lot many things to master.
Okay.
So for that, scripting is going to help you.
Understand.
So for that purpose, scripting I have kept here under the core, because it plays major role in the VLSI design.
Okay, sir.
So I think this brief is enough. I forgot to mention here the private jobs. Private jobs, if you come to the private jobs here, as I mentioned here, most of the private companies, they are there in the VLSI sector. Very few, like government undertaking, are only this SEL, this one.
Okay.
Other than that, I will show you now here. You have this Cadence company. This is the private company. This is one where EC students are absorbed. And there is another company called Synopsys VLSI. Yes, this company. This one, Synopsys. And there is another company, Mentor Graphics. Mentor. All these are for EC, I'm talking, okay?
Yes.
Mentor Graphics. Mentor Graphics. This is another company, and there is another company. Synopsys has come, Mentor Graphics, Texas Instruments is there. That is also for EC instruments. Private, these are private for EC, and there is the analog devices company. All these are private, but top-notch companies, all these are.
Yes.
Xilinx. And there is a Intel. Intel also for EC. And then the AMD. How we can forget AMD? AMD. And Qualcomm. All these are VLSI. Qualcomm. So likewise, these are the top-notch companies: Cadence, Synopsys, Mentor Graphics, Texas Instruments, Analog Devices, Xilinx, Intel, AMD, Qualcomm. All these are for ECE, and they are top companies. All these are private sector companies, not government.
Yes.
So these is we discussed so far: government sector, private sector related to ECE. Now, finally, we come to this one. So, the software related jobs. If at all you want to get into the software side, then you may have to study the market, which side you have to go. Actually, in the software side also, as I mentioned, networking is their domain, system administrator domain is there, and the product development domain is there. In the product development side, people which language they are using. Are they using Java to develop their product? Are they using C++? Are they using .NET? Are they using Python? Like that, you have to understand. For web development, they use XML, some HTML. So them you have to understand product. What is their company product in which you are actually having interest? That also you have to see. Networking, like there are many companies which provide the networking solutions. So there are companies provide the system admin solutions. So what is that you have to do is, now you have to understand, are you good at programming? Then you have to go for the product-based companies which are developing, which language you are good at. If you are not good at, at least if you have interest, in the market, you have to learn for 4 months, some course you have to take, and then you have to try for those software companies which are working in the C++ area for their product development. There are companies, Cisco, for example. Cisco is there in the networking, top company, Cisco company, and of course, Microsoft also is there in the networking. That is also top company. Google is there, top company in the networking. System admin also there, Google. In that side also, you can look into. The thing is, majority of these companies are private sector companies. In the government sector companies, all that I have shown, all are actually EC student, software, even software engineer, they prefer. Mostly all these prefer not EC with EC background. They prefer candidate from CSC or IT background.
Yes.
These companies, especially these government companies, they prefer for their company, for software development, for system related issues, admin or networking related issues, they prefer candidates with a CSC or IT background, not from EC background. In the government company, I'm talking about, in the government sector. In the private sector, no matter. You belong to maybe even commerce side, but you are good at C++. They will see your potential in that C++ and they will hire you.
Yes.
So that's what I have to share with you. I think a bit helpful for you now. You might have got brief idea.
Yes, sir.
So let me summarize very quickly by saying few things. The summary of this our meeting is that there are two sides. One is the core side, the other is the software side. For the core side, we have government sector and private sector. In government sector, several things I have shown you going to their websites. Them you have to refer, and you have to master all these listed subjects. Fundamentals are required. For not, nobody is looking for you. You be master in this DSP. Everybody looking for to solve the basic formulas. Like you have FFT basic formula, like sigma. N equal to 0 to N minus 1, X of N into W power NK, some formula is there. In EDC, some basic formula, like what is the diode current equation? When diode is conducting, what is the diode current equation?
Yes.
So ID equal to IS, that is leakage reverse current, or reverse current, that into what is that?
E power.
Eta Vd divided by
V.
Vt. Eta will come under denominator, I think.
Eta Vt by D.
That minus 1.
1.
So that is required. That fundamental is required. Okay. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So in the, for example, Zener diode. Zener diode, how it is helping us, like a voltage regulator. What is the difference between Zener breakdown and avalanche breakdown? So these are the fundamentals.
Yes.
For every 10 degrees Celsius rise, something happens in the current. What happens in the current?
Current slow down.
Current doubles or something is there. Okay.
Depletion layer doubles.
No. I did ask you about the current.
Yes.
So some relationship is there. For every 10 degrees Celsius, current doubles, something is there. Okay.
Yes.
So that these fundamentals, just I'm giving examples.
Yes.
So in this fundamentals, you should be strong enough.
Yes.
If you are strong enough, you can face these exams, and only a formality interview will be there. After that, you will be absorbed in those top-notch companies. Okay.
Okay.
So the summary is this, that your candidate must be mastering the fundamentals in the core areas mentioned here in this slide. And the candidate, easy candidate wants to get into the company in the software side, he or she has to understand first of all, in which language they are more inclined, having more interest, that language course they have to take in the market from the good institute for 4 months. In the software side also, there are plenty like networking issues they can look into, system admin problems they can look into, they can go for the product development. So they have to understand in which area they are actually good at, and then they have to go for that particular course for 4 months, crash course. So once they have done that crash course, they can develop their resume and they can apply as a fresher for those software companies, private companies. Okay.
Okay.
So once they got shortlisted, and company will see their potential, what they are claiming in their resume. If they are good at, they will be hired in those software private companies. That's how they can start their career. Okay.
Okay. Sir.
So finally, what we can conclude is, according to my suggestion, observation, my suggestion is, EC candidate should focus on the core side. If he or she is focusing on the core side, in long run, they will have job satisfaction. They will really going to enjoy their job. For short-term gains, immediate gains, if they pick up the software side, over the long run, they will lose the interest, because they did their BTech in some and they're doing job in some other. In the short duration, it may not be affecting, but in the long run, definitely they are going to feel that. That's why the final conclusion remarks are that being a EC student, he or she should be focusing on their core side only.